The moment you start, there's no turning back.
Beginning was a very weird feeling. Sometimes I felt like I'm just watching something. I get those like pictures in my mind, and it just goes on and on, and I just sit there and I just enjoy that. My name is Tomasz Dąbrowski. I'm a trumpet player and composer.
And this is about a project I'm about to finish, which is called 30th Birthday, 30 Cities, 30 Concerts.
I'm going to say a few words about this thing that I'm doing, which is I'm playing 30 concerts solo acoustically in 30 different cities all around. And tonight is number 18.
Since playing solo is in general a very special thing, like, how do you approach that? Another thing for brass player is that it's a physical thing. There is a limit to what's like, how long can you play, how long can you perform? And then there's like universal thing for like being a musician, like to keep it interesting.
In the beginning, I thought of it as that's going to be like a gift to myself, that I'm going to learn a lot from it.
And the other side of it was to go to as many places as I can and play in places that are not typical for improvised music.
Det har sådan 12 sekunder af rumpen, ja. Og 12 sekunder op.
Det er rimelig lang tid.
Ja.
This one is kind of medium reverb kind of place. And then I want to do like really dry room and very big room, or like a room with a big reverb. Because there is a lot to what I play depending on the acoustics. Well, actually the very first concert, that was in Tokyo, in Japan. I played in this shop, Disc Union, Shinjuku. So I just asked, yeah, how long should I play? And the guy who spoke a little English was like, yeah, it's okay. You can like play like 30, 40 minutes. So it's cool. And then he said, yeah, and then we want you to talk about it. I said, okay, but who's gonna like translate it? And then the guy just looked at me and said, no, it's not about that. We just wanna hear you talk about it. I would say the first one, it's more horizontal. And today, because of the acoustics, it feels like it's more vertical. When you think about instruments, like with trumpet, you have a certain idea of how the instrument can sound like, or like should, that's even worse, like should sound like. That's also one of the things that I heard so much playing concerts. It's like people coming and saying, yeah, I was there, like listening with my eyes closed, and then I had no idea, how can you make those sounds? How can you make it sound like that? I like to look at it as like a balloon in the air. You don't need to do much for it to stay there. You just need to give it some air and then it's gonna just bounce. Sometimes you just have to correct it and put it back on track.
I read somewhere about the painting technique called sumié. It's vivid in different cultures, like in China and Japan. It has different names in different places. But it's this technique of painting. It's also called one-stroke painting. You have a piece of paper and you have a pen or like a brush. And then once you start, you just keep on going and you have to finish. And what's beautiful about this idea is that, let's say you paint a tree. It's not about only painting a tree. It's also about putting the spirit of a thing that you're painting in it. So by the time, it felt like a great idea for the solo project. And I think it's also more a human way of doing that. Especially in a solo format.
When I started doing this, I thought that at some point someone's gonna like punch me in the face because it's so weird what I do. It's like people love it or hate it. That's what I really like about it. That there is no like anything in the middle. Like you leave no choice. I think people hate it when they try to understand what's happening, or like they have this very strong beliefs in like what music should be like, instead of like being and seeing things for what they are. But then I saw like people that never heard improvised music in their life getting totally like mesmerized.
This way, it was much more than just music. When you see this, the stuff that's like the impact it has, that's very important to me. I mean, I'm not really fond of like playing just to play. It's all about like connecting with other people through music. is a beautiful thing because you don't really need to like speak the same language or anything. You just play and then that's it.
And I don't know what, like, I don't know why, but it's like, what's the thing? Because this is the third recording, and like right now, right after we did it, it feels as it was the best. And I'm wondering if it's because we did it three times, or it's because of the room, it's because of what? I started this thing to get some answers, and it seems like I'm not gonna get any. It's just a lot of like experiences.